Last Sunday, I talked about two virtues that we need in this season of Advent. That was fortitude and temperance. And today, I'll talk about the virtues of humility and patience. Saint Cyprian, bishop and martyr, said on the value of patience, "Patience is a precept for salvation, given us by our Lord, our teacher. Whoever endures to the end will be saved. And again, if you persevere in my word, you will truly be my disciples. You will know the truth, and the truth will set you free." Dear brethren, we must endure and persevere if we are to attain the truth and freedom we have been allowed to hope for. Faith and hope are the very meaning of our being Christians. But if faith and hope are to bear their fruit, patience is necessary. The theme of our readings today is about new Exodus, the deliverance of unfaithful Israelites from Babylonian exile. Prophesied by Baruch during a moment of uncertainty and anxiety, he said in our first reading, "Jerusalem, take off your robe of mourning and misery, put on the splendor of glory from God forever. Up, Jerusalem, stand upon the heights. Look to the east and see your children gathered from the east and west at the word of the Holy One, rejoicing that they are remembered by God." After they have entered the promised land with Joshua, they worship idols again. They committed idolatry, become unfaithful to the covenant, and so they were conquered. Their temple was destroyed, they were exiled and scattered to the four corners of the world. With the destruction of the temple, they can't worship God, and so it disrupted their covenant relationship with God. Corporate worship is at the heart of the covenant relationship between God and His people. Worship perpetuates and expresses the covenant relationship. Prophet Baruch speaks about Israelites returning to Jerusalem along a highway. The phrase, "Every lofty mountain be made low, and gorges be filled to level ground," is virtually a quote from Isaiah chapter 40, verse 3, and actually derived from ancient highway building practices. According to Dr. Bergsma, just as today, when a major road, usually a royal highway, was built in ancient times, the builders will level the ground as much as possible to facilitate ease of travel for the royal entourage. In this reading, the imagery is that the scattered Israelites are now royalty, and God is having a road built for them to return home. Read in conjunction with our gospel today, St. Luke's description of the beginning of the ministry of John the Baptist, Prophet Baruch set the Baptist's mission in the larger context of the prophetic hope for the new Exodus, and its highway is not so much geographical as spiritual realities. Israel's true exile is spiritual rather than physical. The Baptist way of repentance is the true highway by which Israel will begin to travel back to the new temple, which is Christ Himself. The primary problems of Israelites was not the lack of roads. The transportation system in the Roman Empire was, in fact, quite good. If they wanted to return to their ancestral land, they can. However, large groups of them choose to live elsewhere around the Mediterranean, in places where they had found a good living. So the problem was their sins. their spiritual estrangement with God. For this reason, the road that John the Baptist offers is repentance, expressed through the waters of baptism. Every valley shall be filled, refers to the hope and encouragement and new life granted to the poor, the oppressed, and the lowly. Every mountain and hill be made low, refers to the humbling of the proud, the repentance that the strong and arrogant must undergo in order to receive God's salvation. The winding roads and rough ways refer to the twist and turn of human heart, contorted by sin, needs to be simplified or strengthened by honest confession of sin. Talking about confession, this Advent season we have an additional confession time, 5 to 6 in the afternoon, in the evening, every Thursday during Advent season. Our psalm today recalls what God has done for Israelites during the first Exodus. When the Lord brought back the captives of Zion, we were like men dreaming. Then our mouth was filled with laughter, our tongue were rejoicing with rejoicing. The Lord has done great things for us. We are filled with joy. The psalmist, making an act of faith and hope that God will come to help in its present need and that he can do even greater things in the future. Dr. Scanhan said, "This is what Advent readings are all about. We recall God's saving deeds in the history of Israel and in the coming of Jesus. Our remembrance is meant to stir our faith, to fill us with confidence that, as today's epistle puts it, the one who began a good work in us will continue to complete it until he comes in glory. Each of us, the liturgy teaches, is like Israel in her exile, led into captivity by our sinfulness, in need of restoration and conversion by the word of the Holy One. The lessons of salvation history should teach us that as God again and again delivered Israel, in his mercy, he will free us from our attachment to sin if we return to him in repentance." Dr. Bersma have this, the classic hymn of Jordan, on Jordan Banks is the title, and it says, "Then cleanse be every breast from sin, make straight the way for God within, prepare we in our hearts a home, where such a mighty guest may come. May the Blessed Virgin Mary and Saint Joseph help all of us to prepare to welcome the Lord in our hearts, and may we all rejoice that God has remembered us. Amen."